Shannon Sossaman, and I'm an actress. I didn't decide to become an actress. It just happened when I was 21. I was kind of just going wherever the wind was taking me, and I, this casting director of A Knight's Tale saw me, and she wanted me to audition for A Knight's Tale. And I auditioned like maybe 4 or 5 times, and it just kind of took off from there. And then I had a child when I was about 23, and it slowed down very much, and now it's just starting to pick up again, and now I very, very much love it. So now I feel like I'm really fighting for it and really want to do it. But at first it was very like a big push out into the business, and so it made it more. I love music. I love playing music. I'm not very good, but I love playing drums, and I like to play guitar. I like to sing. I love listening to all kinds of music. I have a piano in my house so my son can learn, and I don't know how to play very well, but I like to pretend like I do. He's 7, so I actually have not worked that much since he was born. Not always by choice either, so it's like it was like a blessing from the universe. I've had a lot of time to bond with him. When it gets busy, it's like I feel very rooted in my relationship with him, because he's 7. So I've been lucky. It's been very slow. Well, I grew up in Reno, Nevada, which was a difficult experience. I was there from age 1 to 17, and then I moved to Los Angeles. So most of my life, my formative years were in Reno, and then my ethnicity is what we call a mutt. So I have a quarter Hawaiian Filipino, and then I have French, Dutch, Irish, German, English, and that comes from my mom and my dad and her mom and her dad and then my dad's parents. So it's all very split up. I think I have, I like to laugh. I think that's fun. I crack myself up. So I think that's fun. If I was stuck on an island, I would definitely be making myself laugh all day, which I think is pretty cool quality. I like to watch people. They just seem to, watching someone walk down the street with a bag of groceries or something and imagining that he's going to go home and cook for his family. You know, I always put stories on. Just human beings are so beautiful to me. I just want to feel comfortable, but, feel like myself. So this is something I made for the festival, which I don't think I can wear it to the premiere because everyone will be very mad. I got the shirt at this place called The Way We Wore in Los Angeles, and they just have lots of really beautiful old things. So it's silk, and it was all hand sewn, and then this I had made. I just had the slip sewn onto this piece of lace and had them sort of fasten it. And my style is hiding, but you know what? I'm never really hiding because I feel like I like things that are very dramatic. So even if I'm covering myself up, it's so dramatic that I never can hide. Do you know what I mean? So I don't think I really want to hide. I just want to cover myself up. This is something that Fendi was really nice to give me. This is really cute. It kind of, it's very simple, so this goes high. I like high. Oh, I like this jacket. I've been wearing this jacket a lot here. This one's nice. I like this dress. I would say just to be comfortable and not feel like you have to follow any sort of trend or anything. Just be comfortable and wear what you like so that you are owning it while you're wearing it. That's the best. I don't think there's a right or wrong in fashion, really.